evening, learners. All has to look at this top tab above. It is a subtitle in control. So we want to define what is stock turnover. And the purpose of determining the stock turnover of stores item is to select stock which do not move regularly and also to avoid keeping capital locked up in items which are infrequently used or not used at all. The turnover should be based on monthly calculation and is often expressed in terms of the ratio or proportion of the cost of material used during the period to the average stock held during a period. So, we are being told why we do a stock turnover is to determine the items that are in store and are not being used, because we keep the stock locked in the store, we are wasting a lot of resources which is not supposed to be here wasted. So there is a formula of calculating the stock turnover and we call it rate of stock turnover. So when you are calculating rate of stock turnover, you use this formula, which is cost of item consumed divided by average stock of the material. Now, the cost of item consumed you can be given or it can be left out for you to calculate it. So if you are taught to calculate the cost of item consumed, it will be opening stock plus purchases between minus closing stock. That is the formula. And average stock level, how you calculate it? You take opening, which is operating stock, plus closing stock, which is divided by 2. So we have a calculation here that is going to help us to calculate this, to achieve this. So this this example is the item in the stores shows the result of the opening stock on 1st January 2020 was cash 80,000, purchases between was between date 1 January 2022 date 31st January 2020 was cash 600,000. Then the closing stock on 31st January 2020 was cash 100,000. Then we are told to calculate the rate of stock turnover. Now, having this formula, which is the rate of stock turnover, we write rate of stock turnover, rate of stock turnover, we have said is equals cost of item consumed. And in this case, we're not given the cost of item consumed. So we have known the formula of calculating the cost of item consumed, which is the opening stock. And our opening stock was 80,000. So we write here 80,000 plus purchases between. And we have the purchases between was 600,000. So we write here 600,000 minus closing stock, and we are given what is the closing stock, which was 100,000. So when you deduct, you get 58,800,000 shillings when you divide. So that is the, this is cost of item consumed, cost of item consumed. Now we look at the average stock level, and we have said the formula of getting the average stock level is equals opening stock. We have our opening stock, yes, we have it is 80,000. It is 80,000 plus closing stock, and our closing stock is 100,000. So we write 100,000, so we had divided by 2. So when you add them, you are going to get 90,000. When you divide them, divide by 2, you are going to get 90,000 shillings. So our rate of stock turnover will be the cost of item consumed divided by average stock level. Now the cost of items consumed is that divided by 90,000. When you divide, you are going to get 6.4444. The fours are many, so you will write times. So this is the formula of getting the rate of stock turnover. And it means that there are problems associated with the low stock turnover. If you have low stock turnover in the store, there are problems. One, capital is tied up and cannot be used elsewhere in the business. Number two, there is increased risk of spoilage for sure. If the items are going to be stored in the store, they're going to be spoiled, they will perish. Number three, with unnecessary high stock level, the payroll may be greater than necessary. And number four, the insurance on the stock level, on the stock is higher, which is not necessary. In our next class, we'll look at stock levels.